Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and in today's video we're going to look at the bull flag, the crazy bull flag that's been forming on Bitcoin on the daily chart, which is super bullish. So we're going to have a look at that. We're going to talk Coinbase, we're going to look at different indicators, so make sure that you stay tuned to the end of this video because we're going to talk about a bunch of stuff. So without further ado, let's jump into the Bitcoin chart. So let's see what Bitcoin is doing on the daily chart right now. So there is a huge bull flag that's forming on the daily chart for Bitcoin, which is super, super bullish. Now, the last video I did with DaVinci, and by the way, if you like that video, make sure to leave a like on this one so I know that I can bring back DaVinci and the other crypto guys on the channel as well. So this was the area we were. Let's go to the 4-hourly chart so we can see where we were. So this was the broadening wedge that was forming on Bitcoin on the 4-hourly chart, which we broke to the downside. This was where we left off. Now, if you check the video we did on DaVinci's channel, which I'll put a link to the description below, you can see that we were consolidating at a very particular Fibonacci area, this $17,000 range. It's on the 61.8. You can check that video for more details, but this is a very important range in terms of resistance, $17,000. So if we manage to break up out of this huge bull flag on the daily chart, then we could definitely continue to $17,500. And if we look at volume, we have some pretty good volume. We have the squeeze mob turning up, we have the stochastic going upwards, and the RSI going up as well, which is amazing. And in addition, we have the Bollinger Band squeezing, and we have the Parabolic SAR just fired a buy on the 4-hourly chart. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to BitGet and see our funding record. So in the last couple of trades, we've done super, super well. As you can see, nice and green on the couple of last trades. If you don't know, we're doing a $1,000 trading challenge on BitGet. Demo trading so we can practice our skills as well. I'm probably going to do more funds. I'm going to add more funds to this. We can maybe start doing with real money because I'm really happy with this. So let's see what the future holds, right? But this is pretty good, so we're going to continue with this. I'm also using specific risk management, only 10% per trade of our total portfolio, and we can lose a maximum of 20% in a single trade. Therefore, we only compromise about 2% of our entire portfolio per trade, right? So it's a bit confusing, but watch the previous videos if you want to know more. So let's go to the chart right now. We could actually open a trade right now. I'm going to put a buy order at $17,150. So just so we that, break that previous swing high. So we want to do a trigger order. Trigger order. That's perfect. So we want to do it at $17,150. We'll open a trade market order. We'll do again 10%. So that's around $110. So in terms of take profit, so $17,560. We're almost there. $17,560. Boom. And our stop loss is going to be very, very short at around $17,100. So a very, I'm going to put a bit lower. $17,060. That's what I'm going to do in case we decide to wick down, right? I'm going to do it at, I'm just debating, right? Because we could get stopped out. So I'm going to do it here. $16,945. I think that's a good range, right? $16,950. And I'm just going to buy long right now, and we can continue our calculation later on because we can adjust all of this. So we're going to do 10x leverage, right? No need to be over leveraged. It's cool, right? Just steady wins the long-term game, right? So that's fine. So we put this order so we can calculate it right now and adjust it later on if we have to. So let's see, long position. We'll be longing at 50, so around there. Our take profit will be at 2.4%. So with 10x leverage, that's going to be 24%, which is awesome. And our stop loss is going to be here. So we literally have a 2-to-1 trade. That's awesome. With 10x leverage, the max we can lose is 11%. So we stick by our rules. But yeah, that's perfect. So I think we can reach this resistance if we continue with volume, and then we can reassess afterwards. And we're also above the EMA ribbons, which is lovely. And if we have a look at the funding rates as well, we can see that we have negative funding rates, which is very bullish in terms of the long positions getting paid from the short position. So that's awesome too. Let's have a quick look at the crypto bubbles. FTM is pumping, IMX, TWT. We're seeing a lot of the altcoins pumping right now. You know, I think we may break the altcoin to Bitcoin ratio, which I'll talk about in the next video. But the market cap dominance for altcoins looks pretty healthy. And now in terms of Coinbase, before we finish off, right? Now, Coinbase has not published their reserves, and it's one of the only biggest exchanges not to publish its proof of reserves, right? So we talked about this in our video with DaVinci, which you should check out, right? And the thing is, right, they're saying it's due to security issues, right? Which is, you know, they've given no compelling valid reason, and they say that they hold a bunch of grayscales Bitcoin, right? Which is a bit sus, right? I'm not gonna lie, because, you know, as soon as they went underwater, in heat, grayscale, they just, you know, they couldn't publish their reserves. So Coinbase is like, I'll vouch for you guys, but it's a bit sketchy, right? So I'm not exactly sure why. You know, we know that they're audited, right, by the SEC, but we don't exactly know to the greater extent what they're audited by, right? So you know, my advice is, if you're on Coinbase, right, you know, general advice overall, it's a fact, right? If it's not your keys, it's not your crypto. Right. So just the same way as, you know, if you buy gold on an exchange, for example, unless the physical gold bar is in your hand, it's technically not belonging to you. Right. So this is the same with Bitcoin. So, what I personally do is I only put the amount of Bitcoin I'm willing to trade with and I'm willing to risk on the exchange. Right. And then that's all I do. And I keep the rest in my cold wallet. So that's what I would be, saying. That's what I do. And I think that would be potentially the safest way to protect your assets. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. We also put in a nice little cheeky trade today. Hope to see you guys in the video tomorrow. Take care and see you guys. Bye-bye.